What makes a hero a hero?
It's 4 in the morning, the end of December. I'm writing you now just to see if you're better. New York is cold, but I like where I'm living. There's music on Clinton Street all through the evening. I hear that you're building your little house deep in the desert. You're living for nothing now. I hope you're keeping some kind of record. Yes, and Jane came by with a lock of your hair. She said that you gave it to her that night that you planned to go clear.
On the 6th of January, 1412, in Domremy, Champagne, France, a girl named Joan was born into a world of chaos. Europe was in the throes of the Hundred Years' War, and France was falling behind. A divided country without a king, two factions, the Armagnacs who supported the uncrowned King Charles VII, and the Burgundians who were loyal to the English, were tearing the already weak country further apart.
You'd been to the station to meet every train.
In this time of turmoil, Joan found her peace in God. In 1428, when she was only 16, her story changed from one forgotten in a generation to one immortalized for millennia.
Il y a une besoin que c'est une question de nécessité sérieuse pour que de hu et Charles de Septembre a profité de son royaume pour lui être indiqué mort plusieurs fois qu'un de levet.
She was nobody's wife.
Turned away from Robert Baudricourt, the king's advisor she had been prompted to find, she returned to Domremy. She was soon impressed, however, to try again and convince Baudricourt to take her to the king. This time she succeeded, after winning Baudricourt's confidence with her exact prediction of the defeat of the French in the Battle of Herrings outside the recently fallen Orleans. The king accepted her as a visionary, and she was allowed to begin her self-proclaimed mission of eliminating the English from France as God intended. In March of 1429, Joan led the French attack to reclaim the city of Orleans. Before the battle, she had been prompted to inform the king the French would emerge victorious, and they did. But one victory doesn't end a war. Tension was on the horizon for the French and Joan, but for the moment, the world saw peace. In July of 1429, Charles VII was crowned king in Reims, just as Joan promised. In September of that year, the newly crowned Charles VII wanted to retake the English-occupied city of St. Denis. Although Joan was against the attack, she loyally supported her king and her men in the battle. The result was disastrous. The French soldiers were beaten back, eventually abandoning the effort. Although this loss hurt Joan's prestige, she was made royalty that winter and didn't take up arms again until the following April.
Well, your enemy is sleeping, and his woman is free. Yes, and thanks.
Following an unsuccessful attempt on Paris, Joan and her men were involved in a reckless skirmish. Several days before, Joan had foreseen her capture, and on May 24th, her prediction came true. She was sold by the Burgundians to the English, where she was imprisoned and put on trial for heresy. After extensive questioning, she finally denied her communication with God and was put back in prison. Sexual harassment was common in the prisons, and she refused to wear women's clothing to protect herself. Several days later, she was retried for that reason. This time, she would not deny God's influence in her life and was sentenced to death. Joan burned at the stake in Rouen, France, on the 29th of May, 1431. She was 19 years old. What makes a hero a hero? Courage, honor, valor, determination? Do you have to become a martyr, an icon, or a legend? Maybe being a hero is more simple than that. Maybe all it takes to be a hero is standing up for what you believe in, no matter the consequences. Maybe all it takes to be a hero is doing what's right. 24 years later, in 1455, she was retried posthumously and found innocent. Finally, centuries after her death in 1920, Joan of Arc was sainted by Pope Benedict XV.